Everybody's resting on your feet. Amen. Everybody resting on your feet. Everybody resting on your feet. Amen. This young man that I'm about to bring before you. A young man, old in the ministry, young at heart. Amen. A vision for the young people, a heart for the young people. He was the one that set this youth explosion up. Amen. At this time, amen, I want you to clap your hands for Elder Joseph William. Come on, clap your hands.
The head of my life. Glory to God. Have y'all had a good time so far? Yeah. For those of you who've been here the past 2 days, have you enjoyed yourself? Yeah. Have you come to seek God on tonight? Yeah. Have you come to be delivered, healed, set free? Whatever God has for you, I want you tonight to grab a hold to it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We're going to go straight to the Word. Glory to God. Remain standing. Amen. Go to Ecclesiastes chapter 12. When you have it, say amen. Or if you need more time, say wait. Ecclesiastes chapter 12. I'm going to read from the Living Bible. And then I'll read the King James Version. But my son, be warned. There's no end of options ready to be expressed. Studying them can go on forever and become very exhausting. Here's my final conclusion. Fear God and obey his commandments, for this is the entire duty of man. For God will judge us from everything we do, including every hidden thing, good or bad. King James reads, and further by these, my son, be admonished. Of making many books, there is no end. And much study is a weariness of the flesh. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. For God shall bring every work into judgment with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. The word of the Lord is blessed. You may be seated. Look at your name and say, the conclusion, of the whole matter.
Of the whole matter.
That's the sermon on tonight. We say it one more time, the conclusion.
The conclusion.
Of the whole man.
Of the whole man.
Put those hands together. Hallelujah. Today's time we have our youth. This is the youth explosion, right?
Yes.
Am I right about it?
Yes.
You might have some older folks, but you got some older people do act like young folks.
Hallelujah.
Come on now.
Thank you, man.
You got some folks that ain't grew up yet, but that's all right. But nowadays, our youth are in a state of loving luxury. They're in a state of the fine things that they want. Some of them are worse of bad manners. We can all attest to that we've had some times where we've done things we're not supposed to do.
Well.
Some of them are contempt for authority. Some of them are disrespectful to elders.
Well.
Not elders, but, you know, older folks.
Uh-huh.
That won't give them any attention. Or they love to run their mouths a lot. And to understand that sometimes their mouths can get you in trouble.
Yeah.
Am I right about it?
Amen.
Some of them becoming tyrants of their own home and running their parents wherever they want to and telling them what to do.
Jesus.
Am I right about it?
Right.
All right, you better talk back to me.
Right.
Some of them are not servants of the household talking about, I ain't got to clean up, I go to school, and I ain't got to do this, and I ain't got to do that. Am I right about it? Some of them contradict their parents. A lot of them talk too much. Again, their kids talk too much. Especially in school. My God.
Jesus.
A lot of them like to gobble up food. They can forever feed them. Forever to give them something to eat. It never fails.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Come on, y'all can laugh. That's all right.
It's all right. Preach it.
Yes, Lord. Young people are facing and making choices which stay with you for the rest of your life.
Yes.
In your young age, when you make certain decisions, they follow you down through the years.
Yes.
Am I right about it?
Amen.
This could be your education,
going to school. This could be dating for some of y'all. Some of y'all who are getting out of high school are thinking about marrying people. My God. Some of y'all are thinking about hanging with the cool crowd, about doing drugs and doing alcohol and stuff, and thinking if I fit in and if I do this and do that, then I'll be with the popular folks and people who love who I am. But I come to serve notice that the most important decision on tonight is to serve God. The most important decision is to put Him first. Hallelujah. These I consider to be advice to our young people. Wisdom. So listen closely. There are three R's that I have on tonight. The first R is rejoice in your youth. That comes from chapter 11 and 9, which reads, rejoice, O man, in thy youth, and let thy heart cheer in the days of thy youth, and walk in the ways of thine heart, and in the sight of thine eyes. But know thou, for all these things God will bring thee into judgment. What is that telling me? In the Living Bible, it says, young man, it's wonderful to be young. Enjoy every minute of it. Do all you want. Take in everything, but realize that you must account to God for everything that you do. So banish grief and pain, but remember that that's your youth, with a whole life before it, can make serious mistakes. This is why we come to church. This is why we read our Bible. But being young is a blessing from God. Chapter 12 and 3 and 8 tells us that. Being young gives us strength to overcome some of the things that we go through. Being young allows us to have adventure and try new things and to learn things and explore. When we're young, we want to do a lot. We got a lot of high energy. Because when you read in Ecclesiastes, Solomon is talking about how you get old and you won't be able to do certain things, and your bones start to creak and everything, and your hair turns gray. But while you're young, you got time to do stuff, and you got time to live for God. Well, preacher, you're saying, well, why do I have to live for God? Don't you know that He came down here 2,000 years ago on a hill called Calvary and died for your sins? And I want to let you know that your life is not your own. He died for you so that you wouldn't have to be on the cross. Am I right about it? Come on, witnesses. What's it mean to rejoice? To rejoice is to be glad and to cheer up, to be happy and pursue wholesome pleasure. What are you talking about, preaching? To rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. To rejoice in His word. To rejoice in the things that He's done. Did He wake you up this morning? Did He start you on your way? Did He keep your mind? Because somebody didn't make it on tonight. Somebody didn't make it this morning. But God seen fit to let you come into this place. He seen fit to let you get up. And that ought to be enough to give God some glory. Hallelujah. Remember, some things that we do have to do can be sinful. For wrong, it's not wrong if it's fun. What am I talking about? Smoking, drinking, violence, and things like that. You can still have fun being young. You can still have fun being saved. You can still have fun serving God. You might not be doing the things like they're doing. And some places you cannot go.
Come on.
Some things you cannot do. Some things you cannot hear. But God has called you out of darkness into His marvelous light. When He has a will concerning your life, some things you got to stray away from. And it takes time for some of us. Some of us jump right in it. Some of us, it takes a little bit more time. But I guarantee you, if you lean on Jesus.